What's up, my sub-a-dub-dubs? This is your boy, it's Gyro, and we're going to be playing some Medal of Honor Warfighter on some jungle map that I don't know what the name is of it, so if you guys know the name, be sure to comment below and tell my nub-ass what it is, because I completely forgot, and I don't feel like looking it up, but we're going to be playing with the McMillan TAC-300 sniper rifle once again, which is the very first sniper that you unlock in the game. It's bolt action, and it is kind of sexy. I don't know, I've been having some fun with it and actually doing okay. I've also unlocked the second sniper, which is the semi-auto Labre or something like that. I probably mispronounced it, probably not even the name of the sniper, but anyways, we're just gonna be talking a little bit about Medal of Honor Warfighter. And like I said in my last gameplay, or I think I commented below in the video about the sniping being a lot better than it was in the beta and alpha. And I'm just so happy about that, because the sniping in the beta for me, it was not smooth, it was not accurate, and it seemed most of the time I got 90% kill assist 9 out of 10 times. If you were not completely on their head getting that headshot every time, you were not going to get that kill. And so I did not have very much fun with the sniping class in the beta, but now that the game's out and I'm playing on PC, so that might be more of a help for me of having so much better accuracy to the point. But I do okay in this gameplay. I think I go like 13-5, which is pretty good for me, only being a level 13 compared to everybody else who is playing the game at the moment, is majority of them being plus level 30s, so level 30, level 40, level 50. I see them every day in every game just raping noobs like this, so I don't know. Hopefully you guys enjoy the gameplay. It's okay. It's not a good one, but it's a okay one, I guess. Look at my ragdoll physics. So if you guys want to pick up a free Medal of Honor Warfighter weapon camo, check out the link in the description, and only thing that you have to do is watch the Zero Dark 30 trailer, and then they will ask you what system that you want the code for, and then what you do is link your Origin account through the site, and the next time that you log on to Medal of Honor, you will get a authentic, unique weapon camo that will go on any of the weapons. I've actually yet to check it out, so I don't even know if it's worth of interest to anybody that uses any of the camos. I would say that the camos are kind of funny on this game, because they're just really horribly, how would you say, like, animated to a point. Like, the camo that I got on right now, it's an ugly camo. It just looks ugly. I mean, the pixelation and the color of the camo, it just looks horrible to me. There's a lot of the camos that don't look half bad. They look really good, and I don't know why they decided to go in such a blocky, like, camo style for a lot of the camos that you are able to equip on the weapons. So, I don't know. I would find that running the gun, even without a camo, the guns look pretty nice because it looks like the original guns. So I think that's probably what I'm going to start doing after a while, is just taking off the camos, because I don't know if it allows people to see you like easier, but I would assume me having a white and black sniper rifle on a jungle map like this, you guys can probably see me. So my next question to everybody who owns this game is, how are you guys enjoying the game? Is it fun for you? Is there anything that annoys you out the fucking ass? Like, I know the one thing that annoys me in this game, especially on this map, is people getting on the outside of the fucking map and just camping there, and then anytime that you come running past any of the barriers that are like the barbed wire right there on the left side, you know, someone sprays you down from the bushes and you just can't go up over there and get them because they're outside of the map. So also, they were supposed to do patching on the whole thing of spawning and falling through the map. I don't think they've actually patched it, because I fell through the map multiple times and multiple days previous to playing. So I don't know. But if you guys enjoyed this gameplay commentary, then please slap that like button. If you guys didn't enjoy, then be sure to leave me some constructive criticism. We will be seeing you next Tuesday for some Halo 4. Later.